Servants of God, Bishop Joseph Musa, Bishop Felix Olorunfemi, Venerable Chukwu Nonso Anumba, Mrs. Mercy Ifeanyi Ikide, and all the servants of God. Host, His Grace, the Most Reverend Dr. Henry C. Ndukuba, Primate of All Nigeria and Bishop of Abuja Diocese. Come and experience an unusual encounter at the cross. See you there.
For giving you life, for preserving the life of every member of your family, for making you a part of this blessing. Appreciate God for all the benefits you have received from Him. Appreciate God for all He used to bless you. Appreciate God for the healing. Appreciate God for the deliverance. Appreciate God for the yokes broken. Appreciate God for the souls that have been lifted. Appreciate God. Because it's by the grace of God you are here today. There are many who slept last night and could not wake up this morning. Some went to their places of work, but they don't know how they ended up the day. You are here because the Lord has shown you mercy. The Lord has shown you kindness. The Lord has been gracious to you. We are not better than those who are beneath His feet under the ground. We are not better or more righteous. Beloved, it's by His grace that you are not consumed. Just begin to appreciate God. Thank God for His love, for His kindness, for His goodness, for His continuous protection, for His continuous favor, and for all that He has done for you that even money cannot buy. He loves me. He loves me. On Calvary tree. He loves me. I cannot say why. Oh, my Jesus loves you. Your burden, your trouble, your sorrows are finished. Your pains are gone. Your debt is paid. Beloved, just appreciate God. Begin to thank God for paying the debt that you could not pay, for lifting away your burdens, for lifting away your failures, for lifting away your problems. Begin to celebrate the mercies of God upon your life. Begin to celebrate the kindness of God upon your life. Begin to celebrate His mercy on a daily basis. Because there are people who are better than us. They have been buried and gone. There are people who labored and even more successful than us. They could not live to enjoy the fruit of their labors. But here you are today. It's just by the grace of God. It's just by the love of God. It's just by the mercies of God. Lift up your voice and begin to thank God. Begin to appreciate Him. Begin to celebrate His mercy upon you. Begin to celebrate His kindness upon you. With all that is happening around us, with all the economic challenges, God is still providing for you. God is still providing for your family. On daily basis, you hear people dying of high blood pressure, so many sicknesses. God has demonstrated his love for you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Beloved, as we lift our voices before God this evening, the fourth and the last day of this program, like Bartimaeus, who resisted every obstacle, like Bartimaeus, who refused to give up, who shouted, "Jesus, thou son of David," going to cry for mercy, that whatever that we stand as, that we make the accuser of the brethren to stand to accuse you this evening. Even though when the disciples they shot Bartimaeus down, the Bible said the louder he cried, asking for mercy. In Ezekiel 18:27, the Bible says that if the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness and doeth that which is right, he will save his soul alive. And the Bible says, all have sinned and have come short of the glory of God. Let's begin to ask God for mercy. Let's begin to ask God that he will forgive us, that sin will not be a barrier to our prayers this evening, that sin will not stand as an obstacle to our blessings this evening, that the accuser of the brethren, we have no any ground to accuse us of sin. Because the only obstacle between you and your blessing is sin. Ask God to forgive you. Ask God to purify your heart. Ask God to make you whole. The prodigal son said to himself that, "I have sinned against heaven, against you. I'm no more worthy to be called your son." God is a merciful God who desires not the death of the sinner, but for him to repent and to live. As you lift your voice in repentance this evening, may God show us mercy. May God show us mercy. May God show us mercy. In the mighty name of Jesus, every sin, sin of omission or sin of commission, things left undone and things that we have done wrong, Lord, we cry for mercy. Lord, we cry for forgiveness. Do not the blood of your son shed on the cross of Calvary for the remission of sin. Lord, sin will not be a barrier to our blessings. Only Father, come before you, because you said those who come to you this evening, may you not God, for the vessels that you have prepared to use them. Lord, may you use them. Release your blessing upon your people this evening. That as a minister to us, barriers will be broken. The sick will be healed, oh God. The blind will receive. The lame will walk, oh Lord, in thy name of Jesus. As a minister, this is Jesus. Every agent of devil, every agent to monitor or to cause distraction in this gathering, we prince of darkness, Jesus. Father, we pray that your presence will be made manifest in this gathering. Holy Spirit divine, take over this gathering. Peter and John said to the beggar at the beautiful gate, silver and gold we have none, but in thy name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise. Every other name, may that name do us favor tonight in thy name of Jesus. May that name, oh God, bring us relief tonight in thy name of Jesus. May that name, oh God, bring us healing tonight in thy name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, we pray. The blood of Jesus is a better covenant than the blood of Abel and the blood of animals. Lord, we pray and we split that blood of Jesus upon every individual gathering in this place in thy name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. For in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Let the living say, Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And for those that have testimonies, we would like you to see Reverend Canon Nelson Akiwande at this extreme end, or Reverend Ibele Nwankwo. We shall be taking testimonies immediately after the praise worship. So please take note. In case you have any testimony, please come out and see these men of God. On my extreme left, may I call on the Diocesan Youth Praise Team to lead us in praise worship.
Hallelujah. Let's rise to our feet as we give our Father praise tonight. He's worthy to be praised. He is Alpha, He is Omega, the one who sits in heaven and is clothed in glory. Jesus, we exalt you. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name
Something for Jesus. We thank the Diocesan Youth Praise Team for leading us in this praise worship. And we pray that God will continue to grant you everything it takes to bring glory to His name in all that you do in Jesus' name. And we are going straight to testimonies. And we have just three here. I will call the names, their names, so that they can come over here and stay, so that they can give their testimonies in quick succession. Praise the Lord. We have Mrs. Chukwuma Stella Uche. Please encourage them as they come forward.
Mama Nka Monica, please. I think you can do better than that. We also have Mrs. Adeniyi Florence. I've not seen the first person I called her name. It looks as if men don't have testimony this evening. Do they have? They are afraid. Praise the Lord. Here there is no fear. There is liberty in this place. And they overcame them by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Please. Okay. Mama, please come forward for your testimony. You have just 3 minutes. 3 minutes.
Praise the Lord! I don't know what to say, and I know what to say. I will give God. This is a chicken song. Testimony. Please join me, Unanua. Oh, beam to goes like this. I'm going to come and show you. How? Beacon. You say, I can speak it. Low you go. For December. I went to Ghana. They take me to Ghana. Why do I go to Ghana? It's my, yes sir. I went there because my second daughter Muru. So, oh, you die, you sorry. So that is why. I went there to see the daughter of that, my daughter. She's schooling there. I said, let me go and check how she is. Because when I am out of shadow, only with them. I thank God, I so thank God. Within a week, who has you assumed the other girl? Oh, because. So, they take me to Lagos. When I get to Lagos, so I stay there. I do Christmas and New Year. Then I come back. Okay. In later when I 2 weeks today. I come 2 weeks today. So now my teaching, okay, as God may have it. He brings me back from Abuja to Ghana, from Ghana to Lagos. I don't know what to say. When they put me for Ubone Henenu, there. Ask the man. Is it this aeroplane? Wait, is it going to Abuja? Say yes. I said, why? Why one hand did they do like why would I not take a why not use a chewing gum whole hand? So as you people are laughing, that's how they laugh too. They say it's a government, they will do it after. They ask me, where am I, what state are you from? I say, I'm from Nigeria. So they start to follow me. They say, Mama, can you work with us? I say, one. What am I? Man, I know what. Let me go ride the aeroplane. So that is how I work. Come with in peace and not in pieces. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. I actually depended on the Holy Spirit to teach me and to explain to me, interpret what Mama said. But somebody came, I think sent by the Holy Spirit, to tell me what she has said. And we give God the glory for all the journey mercies, traveling mercies, and everything, and the comfort of the Holy Spirit upon her.
Is able, abundantly able. It has been long that I've been in this case, that case since 2010. So this case started small and they started prolonging it. I thought it's just like a joke. I'm the one that carried this case to the court. And if you have been in the court, you know what I'm saying. Anytime that I'm going to the court, my heart will just break, like even I will die or I won't come back. Oh, they will carry me to Kuje because of the land. I started praying. I cried. Then my husband helped me. We asked this lawyer. The lawyer will not even do it. It was 2019. I heard that the judge died. I said, what can I do? Can I leave the land? My husband said, no, we should continue. And they hand over to another judge. So I had to change lawyer. Before I called, I went to the Way of Cross of 2019. I said, God, enough is enough. Let this be enough and let the judgment come to my own. And God did it for me. It was 2021, then everything died down. And God has stood me and now I've been free. Then all my play, I pray to God that in the presence of our people here, that I'm going to give testimony, and I will tell God that our God is here, and I've paid the pledge, and I've done everything. God has done everything, and He has said to me, praise the Lord!
Well, that which God has done for you and you have come to give Him thanks, God will do more. In the name of Jesus Christ. The third person, is she here? She gave her name yesterday. Okay, if she's yet to come, we pray for these ones that have given testimony. Let us pray very quickly. Gracious Father, we thank you. We appreciate you for these, your daughters. We thank you for your grace upon them and ability to acknowledge that which you have done for them. They haven't taken your grace upon them for granted. They have come to say thank you that it is you that has done it. Take glory, honor, and praise in the name of Jesus Christ. Their testimonies today, O God, we ask that you make permanent in the name of Jesus. We seal their testimonies with the precious blood of Jesus, that Satan will not come and steal it away from them. That which they are testifying to today shall have
several effects upon their lives positively in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, oh God, we ask that, Lord, you keep these ones for your glory all the time. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I think do something for Jesus as they go back to their seats. We are going to take, well, before we take this hymn, it's good we recognize by the grace of God the dignitaries that are here. With us this evening, we have our mother, Mama Nigeria, Mrs. Angela Ndukuba, the wife of our primate and the leader of our church. Mama, we welcome you. What I'm doing this evening, I'm doing it on behalf of the primate, our father, who is unavoidably absent in this service today, but his spirit is with us. We have with us this evening again, we saw him yesterday, the Right Reverend Felix Olorunfemi, the Lord Bishop, Professor Court Diocese, who will be again bringing the Word of God to us. It is a prayer that God will use you mightily this evening to relay His Word to His people, that this assembly will be blessed in the name of Jesus. Sir, we welcome you. Also with us this evening is our own, the Right Reverend Moses Tabwaye, the Lord Bishop of Gwagwalada Diocese. As a matter of fact, is representing the primate here this evening. He's here in two caps. I think you should clap for him. Like he has been doing, he will be interpreting what the preacher will be saying in Gbagi language. And we pray that God will give both of them utterances tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. We shall take the hymn, Church of Nigeria, hymn 822, My Hope is Built on Nothing Less. This we usher the man of God to the microphone.
All of the ground is sinking. Let us pray. His oath, his covenant, his blood. Support us in the whelming flood. When all around our souls give way, he then is all our hope and stay. Lord, we dedicate this hour to you. Holy Spirit, brood over this meeting this evening.
Amen.
As your word comes, we pray for inspiration.
Amen.
Lord, it is the last day in the program, The Way of the Cross, for the year 2024. Father, no one shall go home empty.
Amen.
Lord God Almighty, as we approach your holy throne by the blood of the new covenant, Father, make way for us this evening.
Amen.
Lord God Almighty, refresh us with your presence.
Amen.
Tonight, burdens shall be lifted.
Amen.
Sicknesses shall be healed.
Amen.
Yokes shall be destroyed.
Amen.
Tonight, there shall be full restoration.
Amen.
Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. We give thanks to God for another opportunity to fellowship this evening. Once again, I want to appreciate our Father, the leader of our church, our Father, the Most Reverend Henry Ndokuba, the primate of all Nigeria, for the opportunity given to us to stand before this great people of God this evening. It's our prayer that the Almighty God will continue to strengthen him as he leads the Church of God in our time, in the name of Jesus. Baba may not be here physically, but he is right here with us in the spirit. I sent a text to him this morning, because when I woke up this morning, I woke up very happy. I had a dream that I was kneeling here praying alongside other people,
and
Baba came and put his hand on my head and started praying for me. So when I opened my eyes, I said, I think I have received impartation for tonight. So may the Lord be with him wherever he is, and may the Lord reach us through his power tonight in the name of Jesus. Let me also appreciate our Mama Nigeria.
Yes, Mama Nigeria, but Mama Africa.
We thank God for the grace of God upon you, Mama.
It's
our prayer that the Lord will continue to strengthen you in this work. We thank you and we thank Baba Prime. May the Lord bless your ministry in Jesus' name. I must also thank my father here. Praise the Lord. So, Baba Gwagwalada, thank you, sir. I pray God will use us tonight.
Amen.
Amen. It's the last day today. And every last day is always full of grace. Every last day of every program.
It's
a summary of all the events. And a time to deliver all the blessings. So tonight you will not return empty. In the name of Jesus Christ. You know, Baba Primate says something yesterday. You know, in John chapter 6, Jesus gave a lot of teachings. And in chapter 7, the last day of the feast, he cried out with a loud voice, saying to the people, anyone who thirsts, said, let him come. And I know there are thirsty people tonight. Just like we said yesterday, that thirst makes water precious. So tonight, whatever is your thirst or your hunger, the Lord will meet you at that point in the name of Jesus. So the topic before us this evening is the power in the blood of Jesus. The power in the blood of Jesus. And the text apportioned for this particular evening is Hebrews chapter 10, verse 19. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus. So what gives us access into the presence of God is the blood of Jesus. And that is what gives boldness. Just like we said yesterday, when sin came into the garden, the sin of disobedience, Adam lost his confidence. His boldness was taken away. He began to look for where to hide. And that is what sin does. Sin takes confidence away from man. It removes boldness away from man. Check when a thief is caught or when a criminal is caught. Every boldness disappears. That man, when he holds his gun, you know, in the night, brandishes the gun, he's full of confidence. He's full of boldness. But the moment he's caught in the net of the authority, his head is bowed like one dead vegetable. And they say, raise your head. That is the same man. Before he was caught, he had boldness. Sin robs a man of boldness. You cannot appear before God as a sinner. But the Bible tells us, therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus. So we thank God for this access we have. Tonight the Lord will meet us at the point of our need. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yesterday we're told that by the blood of Jesus, we who were far off are brought near. What an amazing grace. And I'm sure you will permit me to do what I'm used to. Amen. Just sit down, take it, then reflect. Where you were some years back. Reflect some of the acts you carried out. There are some things I remember today about my past
And I asked, how? How did I get into this? And I'm sure you are also here like that. What an amazing grace. Amazing grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Verses sung. Grace, grace, God's grace, grace that will pardon and bless within. That liberates. I repeat, is always greater than the force that enslaves. That force that brought you from afar off is stronger than that grace, that force that pushed you far away. The strength of the oppressor is the maintenance of ignorance. As long as your oppressor can keep you ignorant of the truth, the oppressor has you in his net. Jesus said,
yes,
you will know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So man's greatest responsibility is the acquisition of truth. That remains our greatest asset in life. And tonight, the Holy Spirit is going to take us deeper into this divine truth that liberates. Abraham's descendants found themselves in Egypt. That was the prophecy in Genesis chapter 15. After Abraham offered sacrifices unto God, God said to him, he said, know certainly that your descendants will be strangers in a land. A land that is not theirs. And they will serve these people. He said they will be afflicted 400 years. And also the nation whom they serve, he said, I will judge. And afterwards, I will bring them out with great possessions. You are not living here empty tonight. I said, you are not going out of this place empty tonight. There shall be restoration. I said, there shall be restoration. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes.
So they found themselves in Egypt. If you read the history of these people in Egypt, you will agree with me that it was a very traumatic time for the children of Israel. Especially when Joseph was no more. And another Pharaoh who did not know Joseph came on board. It was affliction upon affliction. It was oppression upon oppression. It was a period all the children of Israel lost their male children to the Nile River. Every male child that was born that time ended up in the river. What a painful thing. Imagine a woman carrying pregnancy for 9 months. And the woman is praying, Jehovah, I don't want to give birth to a male child. Because he knew the end result of the pregnancy. If that birth turned to a male child, if the delivery turned to the birth of a male child, then that child straight to River Nile. It was a painful time. And the Bible says, a time came. The children of Israel cried to God. And God remembered the covenant. Tonight, He will remember the covenant. I said He will remember the covenant. You may have been weeping silently, secretly, for a cause you and God know. But I announce to you tonight that the Lord will meet you at that point, and it shall be a testimony in the name of Jesus Christ. So as soon as God remembered the covenant, then He began a process of liberation. He started a process of liberation. How to redeem His people from the captivity of Pharaoh, the captivity of the Egyptians, the captivity of the tax masters. It was a painful time for Israel. And the word of God records that God plagued Egypt. He plagued Egypt. The first plague came. Pharaoh replicated. The second one came. The powers of Egypt replicated. The third one came. The powers of Egypt replicated. The fourth one came. They tried to replicate. It was difficult. And the magician, all the powers that Pharaoh gathered around him, they said to Pharaoh, this one is the finger of God. Tonight, the finger of God will come upon your matter. I said God's finger will come upon your matter. That finger is stronger than the strongest power in the world. Every effort to replicate this one did not work. And immediately they attributed it to a divine power at work. Tonight, the power of God will work on your behalf. I say it will work on your behalf. I say it will work on your behalf. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
And from that time, God took over. He took over. The fifth plague came. Pharaoh was still adamant. Let my people go, that they may serve me. Let my people go. Pharaoh refused. The same way God is speaking to that power holding you. Let my people go. The truth is, nobody can serve God in captivity. Nobody. Nobody. You remember the children of Israel? By the rivers of, there we sat, and there we wept when we remembered Zion. Thank you.
found. Whenever you remember Zion, how things were with you, when things were rosy, when business was flourishing, when the joy of marriage was sweet, whenever you remember, the devil comes to you and he says to you, daughter, sing. And the Holy Spirit comes to you and says, sing. And you say, how can we sing the Lord's song when I'm in captivity? The truth is, people in captivity cannot worship God. That is why God said to Moses, go to Pharaoh. Tell Pharaoh, let my people go, that they may serve me. Whatever is holding you back from serving the Lord the way you should, I announce to you tonight that power will give way.
Yes, yeah.
We are talking about the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. The sixth plague came. Pharaoh said, go. But don't go with your flock. In fact, don't even go far. At the time he said to Moses, you may sacrifice even in this land. And Moses said, how can we sacrifice the abomination of Egypt in their presence?
Won't
they stone us? The word of the Lord to us is, go. We are not leaving any pin behind. Tonight, full restoration is coming your way. I say, full restoration is coming your way. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
The seventh plague came. He was the adamant. The eighth plague came. This man would not let them go. Even when God said 400 years before that time, the nation they serve, he said, I will judge them and I will bring them out with great possession. This power held the children of Israel bound. The ninth plague came and Pharaoh refused. And God said to Moses, one more thing I will do. There will be a Passover. Tonight, there will be a Passover. I said, tonight, there will be a Passover. I don't know, there's a song we used to sing in the 80s. Whether it's familiar, I don't know, but permit me. He says, Christ our Redeemer died on the cross, died for the sinners, paid all his due. All who received him need never fear. Yes, he will pass over you. When I see the blood, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. A Passover. So God instituted a Passover. And he commanded them to kill a lamb without blemish. Smear the blood on the lintels and the doorposts of their houses. And that was going to be God's last card. Somebody say last card. I say somebody say last card. Tonight, the Lord will put that blood upon you afresh. Upon your marriage afresh. Upon your children afresh. In the name of Jesus. God announced the death of the firstborn of man and beast, the Egyptians. And this is what God said in Exodus chapter 12, verse 12. He said, "For I will pass through the land of Egypt on that night, and I will strike firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast, and against all the gods of Egypt. Whatever altar that is fighting you tonight, the blood of Jesus will speak on your behalf. In the name of Jesus, God said, and against all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgment. He said, now the blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. This will be your portion tonight. In the name of Jesus. God executed judgment on Egypt. It was a mighty release. Just one night. Tonight, whatever is holding you in captivity shall surrender. Ultimate power is in the blood of Jesus. Every other power shall be humiliated tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let me reiterate again that the force that liberates is always stronger than the force that enslaves. When this last card came on board, that is what we call the Joker. Those of us who played cards in those days, you know, when you have a joker, do you fear anybody? As long as it's in your hand, you don't have fear. Come from any angle, you have the winning card. Tonight, the blood of Jesus will speak on your behalf. I say it will speak on your behalf. As the blood speaks on your behalf, every opposition shall come to an end. Every oppression shall come to an end. In the name of Jesus. That night, the Bible says, when Pharaoh woke up and all the people in his palace, he sent a message, SOS, to Moses and Aaron. Come quickly. Take the people. Get out of my land. Tonight, that enemy will receive divine instruction. I said he will receive divine instruction. In the name of Jesus. Egypt is a kind of bondage. Egypt is cruel slavery. Egypt represents intense hardship. Egypt represents hopelessness. Hopelessness that is fueled by wicked oppression. There are many things today that put us in Egypt. But I say to you, there is hope. There is hope by what I call by divine transgenerational extension of the blood operation. Tonight, the blood of Jesus will speak on your behalf. That bondage shall be destroyed. That captivity shall be destroyed. In the name of Jesus, this blood covenant is transgenerational. Because in Exodus chapter 12, in verses 24, 14 and 24, God said, so this day shall be to you a memorial, and you shall observe this thing as an ordinance for you and your sons forever. So it is transgenerational. People of God, tonight, no destroyer will be allowed to strike you anymore. In the name of Jesus Christ, as soon as the blood covenant was instituted, as soon as the Passover was instituted, the wind was taken off the sail of the oppressive Egypt. That day, their horses, their chariots ended up in the Red Sea. Tonight, the enemy after you will end up in the Red Sea. They will end up in their destruction. In the name of Jesus. Let me tell us again that sin is man's greatest tragedy. Sin brings punishment from the presence of God. Every sinner is dead in trespasses. Every sinner is hopeless. I am not begin to mention sin, lie, fornication, this one. No, you know. Because one of the things the Holy Spirit will do, the Bible says it, that when the Holy Spirit calls, in John chapter 16, he says he will convict men of sin. He will convict men of righteousness. He will convict men of judgment. The sinner knows that Jesus is sinner. The sinner knows that he is a sinner. If you are here, you are not in Christ. You have not been bought with the precious blood of Jesus. You have not been cleansed. You know you are dead in your sins, in your trespasses. You are hopeless. For tonight, the only solution for the problem of sin is the shedding of the blood of Jesus, the sinless Son of God, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the whole world. It is the blood of Jesus that gives us access, boldness into the presence of the Lord. Tonight, you must not ignore this night. The invitation is very, very strong. Because this is the last day of this program for 2024. The way of the cross is open to someone. The blood of Jesus is waiting to wash someone tonight. And it's my prayer that you will embrace the work of Jesus on the cross. It's my prayer that tonight you will be washed. It's my prayer tonight that the power of sin will be broken. It's my prayer that tonight you will find pardon in the name of Jesus. Beloved, our redemption is based on the principle of remission. All that was against us and could never be against us, they are all relieved of their powers to hold us to judgment. Because the blood of Jesus has obtained for us forgiveness, divine favor, liberty, and we are free in the courts of heaven. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. The blood of Jesus, we are talking about the power in the blood of Jesus.
Yes, I mean.
Let me say to us that the blood of Jesus is a weapon of war.
It's
a weapon of war. The word of God tells us in Psalm 103:20 that angels excel in strength. Angels excel in strength. One single night, one angel killed 185,000 soldiers of King Sennacherib. Where they camped, the angel of the Lord came, just one, and he killed them. 185,000. They excel in strength. Daniel, as he was seeking the face of God concerning the people of Israel, the Bible says, he knelt down as he was praying. He turned to 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. Then on the 21st day, Angel Gabriel appeared. And he said, "Oh, Daniel, he said, I was sent to the message, but I was heard. By the Prince of Persia, he could not." Verse 20 tells us, both spiritual and physical. Till we die, until Christ comes. In Revelation chapter 12, the Bible said there was war in heaven. Not fight. Fight is different from war. There was war in heaven. There was a plan to take over government. And the word of God tells us that Michael and his angels fought. The dragon and his angel fought. It was a fierce battle. A fierce battle for supremacy. Angels excel in strength. But they could not prevail. The Bible tells us that victory came when the blood of Jesus came up on the scene. The Bible says they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. That is to tell us that the blood of Jesus is powerful. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
Yes, I mean.
By the blood of the Lamb.
Yes, I mean.
By the blood of the Lamb.
Yes, I mean.
It is this blood that guarantees our victory.
Yes, I mean, my guy.
We fight battles every day.
We fight battles.
Family battles. Business battles. Health battles. Ministry battles. Economy battles. Spiritual battles. All manner of battles. But I announce to you that victory comes by the blood of Jesus. And tonight, God will give you victory. Over that battle, God will give you victory. If you believe that, shout a louder amen.
Amen.
The word of God tells us that Satan's ministry came to an end in heaven when they applied the blood of the Lamb. In
1
John chapter 5 verse 8, the word of God tells us that there are three that bear witness on earth: the spirit, the water,
but the new one,
and the blood.
But the shekwa me.
And these three agree as one.
There are
three that bear witness on earth: the spirit, the water, and the blood. And
these
three agree as one. Let me announce to us again that the blood of Jesus is a stronghold.
It's
a stronghold. I just say it's a stronghold. It's a stronghold. When Saul was after David, he ran into the bush. And the Bible says, and he began to dwell in strongholds. It's a place of safety. It's a place of security. I'll share a testimony with you. A very good brother. Very good brother. He's still alive. Very dedicated. A graduate from the University of Lagos. Many years we were together in Lagos. Dedicated brother. Born again. But under serious oppression. Every night, powers will come. Beat him. They will beat him. And he will urinate on his phone. It was a battle. He prayed, fasted. Every night. He says once it is 12 midnight, like the ceiling will open. And these Lilliputians, if you read Gulliver Travel, many, you know what I mean. Short demons coming from the ceiling, from up there. He said they jump like Chinese people, and you hear the sound here.
Boom.
Once they hit him 2-3 times, he will urinate. And one day he said, if I carry foam, sir, in the daytime to go and put it in the sun, won't they ask me what is happening? Not that rain fell and maybe you assume there's leakage. You don't have children to say, oh, they mistakenly pour water on your phone. What is a young graduate doing with foam every morning outside? Is that not an embarrassing situation? Someone, you are here and you are going through embarrassment. You can't share it with people. But tonight, the Lord will meet you at that point. In the name of Jesus. So he said one day, he got mad in the spirit. And he prayed. And he called on the blood of Jesus. Father, tonight, I am tired of this battle. Lord, cover me with your blood. Father, cover me with your blood. Lord, cover me with your blood. And he went to sleep. And when it was 12 midnight, as usual, the ceiling opened, and he saw them. This is testimony I'm telling you now. That he saw them, and they were all saying, "Who will go first?" You know, they do like Chinese playing karat.
He
said, the first one took a leap. And he rolled over. So he was looking at them. There was a transparent glass. Now covering him. Is somebody hearing me? He said he looked. They were seeing him, but they didn't know that there was something around. And he went up again. And he came down with fierceness. And he rolled over. He said they came. They tried to touch. But look at him now. What is preventing us? I said that was the night oppression stopped. That was the last time he wee on his phone. The blood of Jesus is a stronghold.
Yes, I mean,
a stronghold. A stronghold is a place of power. It's a place of safety. I have talked about David running from Saul. He dwelt in the stronghold in the wilderness. Even Israel was preserved in Egypt. When they marked their buildings with the blood of the Lamb. The blood of Jesus presents to everyone. Such a place of refuge. A place of safety. From Satan and all his attacks. And the word of God tells us. In Zechariah chapter 9. Verses 11 and 12. Zechariah 9, 11 and 12. He says, as for you also, by the blood of your covenant, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. This is God speaking to us. As for you also, by the blood of your covenant, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to the stronghold, you prisoner of hope. Even today, I declare, I will restore trouble to you. Somebody shout amen. God is speaking to us tonight. There is the blood covenant which God has initiated through the death of Jesus. And God is beckoning to all of us. He says, enter the stronghold. He said, by this stronghold, you have been delivered from the waterless pit. Nobody digs a pit to get water. A pit. The aim of digging a pit is not to get water. As many that are programmed to die prematurely, tonight that death sentence is canceled. I said the death sentence is canceled. If you believe that, shout a louder amen. The word of God says that whoever has dug a pit shall fall into his own pit. So I say to you, whoever has dug any pit for you, waiting for you to fall into the diggers of pit, they shall go into their own pit. In the name of Jesus. Tonight, every oppression over your life shall come to an end. In the name of Jesus. People of God, we need knowledge. We need knowledge. Because knowledge is power. I told you how I read the book on the blood. And I didn't understand.
I asked God, what does it mean? And that same night, he gave me revelation of what it means. The blood of Jesus is powerful. The blood of Jesus is a stronghold. The blood of Jesus is for warfare. And tonight, every battle against your life comes to an end. They meet their Waterloo in the blood of Jesus. The same way the Egyptians and all their chariots perished in the Red Sea. That same way, your enemies shall be drowned tonight. In the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The speaking blood. The speaking blood. Whatever speaks has a voice. Amen. Whatever speaks has life. Whatever speaks loud enough for God to hear is not a common voice. Whatever speaks and gets God's attention to send blessing or curses is an institution. Is someone hearing me tonight? Balaam understood this principle. Balak called him, the king of Moab. He said, I see your people. Numerous. Blessed. Please come and change their blessing to a curse. And Balaam went. Before then, God told him, I have blessed. You cannot reverse it. Your blessing is irreversible. So when Balaam came, Balak said to him, after taking him up the mountain, he said, look, I know you have the grace to turn blessing to curses. Please do that for me. And Balaam said, you know what? You will build an altar for me. And he will present seven bulls and seven rams so that I can connect very, very well. Blood was needed. The blood of bulls, the blood of rams. He said, build seven altars, seven bulls, several rams. And on each altar was a bull and a ram. And he picked up his first oracle. By the time he looked, he began to speak the mind of God. I see a great people. This is Israel. The shout of a king is in their midst. I have not beheld iniquity in Jacob. God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. As he said, and will he not do it? As he spoken, and will he not bring it to pass? I have received a command to bless. He has blessed, and I cannot reverse it. And Balaam said, stop! Balaam said, stop! I didn't bring you here for this. I said, curse them. You have entered up, blessed them. And he said, you know what? Take me to another angle where I can see them clearly. And he was taken to another angle. He said, you know what? You must present seven bulls again and several rams. So, several altars.
14 altars. 14 bulls. 14 rams to change somebody's blessing. Tonight, the blood of Jesus will speak on your behalf. He could not curse the people. So we are talking about the blood of Jesus, the speaking blood. So anything that speaks as a voice, anything that speaks as life, anything that speaks enough for God to hear. So, and God sends blessing and curses must be an institution. Can kill this brother. The word of God says the best blood cried from the ground. Because of that, God placed a curse on Cain because his brother's blood spoke. In fact, I don't know how to say this, but let me say it. Since yesterday, you may be here. You have been living under serious guilt. With every effort to be free, you forget, then a day comes, there is a remembrance. You know why? Sometime in the past, something happened. You were involved in incest. Whether with your brother or your sister or with your child. It's a very serious matter. You have been in guilt. God wants to. He wants to help you. Because what you went into was a very strong blood covenant, a bond, and it's a serious matter. Once in a while, you remember. When something happens, is it because tonight is your night? You may have been involved also.
Yeah, you would not have
in another pain. Blood covenant. Maybe through incision.
And,
This one licked this one's blood, the other one did the same. The truth is, what you took in was the life of that person. Because blood is life. And it has power. Tonight, the Lord will also set you free. Let me also say this. Maybe you've been involved in cultism. And along the line, you pulled the trigger. And blood was shed. Life is speaking. Abel's blood cried out from the ground. And the Lord heard.
The scripture is saying something to these people this evening. Let me also add this. Maybe you were involved in a hit and run. Hit and run. You never waited to even render help, and it led to a loss of life. Nobody knows except you and God. Tonight, the Lord is giving you an opportunity. Tonight, blood is very powerful. It speaks. In Hebrews chapter 12, verses 12 to 20. 22 to 24, the Bible says, but you have come to Mount Zion, the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels, to the general assembly of the church of the firstborn who are registered in heaven, to God the judge of all, to the spirit of just men made perfect, to Jesus the mediator of the new covenant, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaks better things than the blood of Abel. Whatever blood that is crying against you tonight, the blood of Jesus will speak for you. The same earth that opened its mouth to receive Abel's blood, it brought a curse on Cain. It is that same earth that received the blood of Jesus Christ. So the blood of Jesus sounds in heaven's court.
So yes, I mean,
cry for peace. Cry for health. Cry for prosperity. Cry for security. Cry for your favor. Cry for your mercy. Cry for restoration.
It's
the same blood that this earth drank. In 2020, that was the year I was enthroned. The COVID lockdown, I was just in the house one day, I got a message that my priest was kidnapped. On a Sunday evening. So the next day I drove to his church. I met the Anglican, I met the church praying. As I called there, the kidnappers called. And I don't know what they did to him over there. He screamed. And he started begging. And the wife said, Bishop is here. Then the Anglican said, don't say Bishop. The phone. The
pastor,
and the kidnapper said, how much have you gathered? They were asking for 5 million. During COVID lockdown, I just took over a sea. No money. No church service. Where will I get 5 million? And they said only 209,000 or thereabouts. And they used whatever to abuse them. 5 million. And I came to the house.
Then the priest, the Anglican called me and said, the young man is under torture of bishop. What do I do? I said, he's begging. If they can pay him his salary up front. I said, from where? How much is his salary? So, on Tuesday, I called the workers. As everybody put on white castle. Let's cry to God. And we gathered in the church to pray. Made all declarations. And I came home. In the night, I was tired, so I climbed my bed. As I was sleeping, something woke me up. You are on the bed. On a very soft foam. You don't even know what is happening to your priest. So I left the bed. And I now laid on the even though comfortable, I said, let me feel the pain of this young man. And I said, Lord, I know your word tells us that we were not redeemed with silver and gold, but with the precious blood of Jesus. You paid ransom for this young man even before the foundation of the world. I have no ransom to pay. Father, I said, we decree. The same way Peter escaped, this pastor must escape. And I prayed. And I laid on the floor. I had a dream. God will visit someone tonight. In the dream, I heard Ojuko has escaped. So I opened my eyes. I said, Ojuko has escaped. Ojuko has escaped. Ojuko has escaped. And I went back to prayers. This was Wednesday morning. To cut the long story short. During my morning prayer, I announced to my family, I said I had a dream that Ojuko escaped. So we are going to pray and thank God. As I finished prayer, a call came to my phone. It was the Anglican. And the Anglican said, my Lord, Ojuko has escaped. Tonight, the blood of Jesus will speak for your escape. I said, the blood of Jesus will speak for your escape. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are talking about the speaking blood. Tonight, that blood will speak on your behalf. In the name of Jesus. Let me tell this last one. One of my parishioners, a very young sister, but full of torment. One day, they said she just stripped herself naked and ran into the bush behind the house. And they started looking for her. They found her, brought her. He started behaving like someone, insane. And after that month, everything became normal. The following year, as soon as it was getting to the month, the signs of his sanity started again. And there is a particular sore. A saw, like a wound, that will come up as soon as the moon is about to, to come up. And once that saw comes, then the signs of insanity will begin. She will just strip herself and run into the bush. And they start looking for her. And they brought her. We prayed. We had all night. Our father was with us that night. So after we're done with the prayer, the night prayer, we had a meeting to go to the house. So we drove around 3 a.m. to our father's house to pray. While we were praying, I heard a voice. So, and I said, I'm hearing something. I said, I'm hearing a voice speaking from the grave. From the grave. From the grave. And I said,
get ready for a divine encounter like never before. Come and experience the breeze of spiritual upsurge. The Diocese of Abuja Anglican Communion invites you to the 2024 Diocesan Annual Lenten Meditation, titled The Way of the Cross 2024. Theme, The Blood of Jesus, A Better Covenant. It's a season of consecration, exposition, miracles, and impartation, happening from Sunday 3rd to Wednesday 6th of March.
He said, my father did not like my wife at all. And I said, what your daughter is suffering is coming from your father. And tonight, that particular night, said the blood of Jesus,
yes, I mean,
will silence the voice of your father. Whatever voice is speaking from to you, speaking against your destiny, from any symmetry, tonight the blood of Jesus will silence the voice. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are talking about the speaking blood. The speaking blood.
Yes, I mean.
Jesus' blood.
Yes, I mean.
Speaks better things than the blood of Abel. Quickly, as we begin to tie up, other reasons why the blood of Jesus is powerful. Number one, it is powerful because of
get ready for
this cleansing power. There is no detachment.
I am
cleansed from sin. It is the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus.
Yes, I mean.
Is powerful. We have the forgiveness of sin. That makes it powerful. It's powerful. Because through this blood, we who were far off have been brought near because of the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus,
yes, I mean,
is powerful because through it we have boldness to enter the holiest. It is powerful.
Yes, I mean,
the blood of Jesus,
yes, I mean,
is powerful because through it we were made alive in Christ. We were raised up with him and we are seated with him in the heavenly places. Far above principalities and powers. God can take a sinner from the pit of sin and sit him in the heavenly places. Must be powerful. That is what makes the blood of Jesus powerful. The blood of Jesus,
yes, I mean,
is powerful because of his unlimited victory. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
Yes, I mean,
and by the word of their testimony. The blood of Jesus,
yes, I mean,
is powerful because by it we stand justified before God and the God of heaven.
Yes, I mean,
the God of heaven has declared us not guilty because of the blood of Jesus.
Yes, I mean,
The blood of Jesus is powerful because of his sanctifying power. It is powerful. Tonight, this blood will work for you. I said this blood will speak for you. In the name of Jesus. When I got married, just one night, my wife just woke up holding her chest, my heart, in the middle of the night, I tried to raise her. She screamed. So I left her. My heart.
So
what is this? I had no vehicle. No phone was at that time. There was nothing like phone. Where do I run to? So I went inside the
toilet.
I stood there. I said, Father, what do I do? And he said to me, go and serve our communion. Is somebody hearing me? There is power in the blood of Jesus. So I went straight, got the element, and I prayed on it, and I looked at her. I said, I married you not to kill you, and I brought you to this city not to bury you. I am going to serve you the body of Jesus and the blood of Jesus, and whatever it is, I arrest it. This cardiac arrest, I arrest you in the name of Jesus. And I gave her the communion. Look, I don't know how to describe it. It was not up to 2 minutes. It wasn't up to 2 minutes. Her hands went off. And she turned. I said, just like that. Tonight, Jesus' blood will do you good. In the name of Jesus. When she was to have the first baby, that was another challenge. Few days to the time of delivery, the blood pressure went up. And we kept going to the hospital morning and evening. Because the doctor said, what is going on? Mother, what is going on? Reverend, what is going on? I couldn't understand. Are you overworking this woman? I do virtually everything. And they will give tablets. Take half. Half will not work. Take one. One will not work. Take one and half. Nothing worked. We were just going morning and evening. This particular morning, I said to her, what's your problem? Are you afraid? She said no. I said, then where is this thing coming from? The doctor said this thing is dangerous. What do we do? I said, anyway, I'm going to serve you communion. Somebody say communion. I said, someone say communion. I said, I will serve you, and your blood pressure will go to normal. After praying, I served her and I put her in the vehicle straight to the hospital. When we got to the hospital, the doctor took her in. Hallelujah. I sat in the waiting room. Then after some time, the doctor came out and said, Pastor, the BP is normal. And it's like she's in labor already. He said, you go. Around 6 p.m., come. Before it was 6 p.m., you know what I mean? That was it. And that was the day the baby came. Look, there is power in the blood of Jesus. That blood will work for you. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
This same blood.
Yes, yeah.
Turned the lady's genotype in one of the services we had. from SS to AA. After going around, and I spoke about the power in the communion. That is the covenant. Jesus said, this is the new covenant in my blood. Don't rationalize with this small brain.
It's a mystery.
This story is a testimony about someone. I read it in one of the church growth magazines. A preacher was preaching somewhere. And as he was preaching, he said, the devil told him, your children will be killed. So he had to agree with his host. And they drew the bloodline. They just heard a prayer of agreement. Father, we draw the bloodline around my children, around my home, in the name of Jesus, the bloodline. And that was it. 2 days after, his younger brother went to check on the children, and to his amazement, he saw 3 foxes dead at the boundary. The boundary to his compound. 3 at different places. Said when he took them for examination, it was discovered that those foxes had rabies. They could not penetrate. The Lord will build a hedge around
you.
5 ways Jesus shed his blood. 5 ways he shed his blood. Number 1, through sweat. In Luke chapter 22, verse 24, the Bible says, and being in agony, he prayed more earnestly. Then his sweat became like drops, great drops of blood. Number 2, through scourging, beatings. Isaiah 53, verse 5. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquity. When he was wounded, blood flowed. Number 3, through thorns. The Bible says they clothed him with purple and they twisted the crown of thorns on his head and they struck him on the head. Mark chapter 15:17-19. Number 4, through nails, the nailing on the cross. The word of God says, and he bearing his cross went out to a place called the place of a skull, which is called in Hebrew Golgotha, where they crucified him. John chapter 19:17-18. When they nailed him, blood came out. The final point, through spear. He was pierced. John chapter 19, verse 34. He said, but one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear. And immediately, blood and water came out. Before this piercing, the Bible said when Jesus saw that everything had been accomplished, he lifted out his voice and cried, it is finished, and gave up the ghost. It was after that this soldier came and pierced, and water. Beloved,
Amazaji.
tells you no blood was left in the vein of Christ. You and me. Logically or medically, through our blood vessels, the last drop, the ground collected it all, required on the altar, was fully paid for our redemption. That is what makes the redemption. No more blood was left. About such
and I
would like you, those you want to
give,
or you were involved in an act, all those things I mentioned, and you've been in trouble. This is the hour. The hymn writer said, Rock of ages, cleft for me. Let your water and your blood from the riven side, the side what that was pierced, be of sin and double cure. He's here for you tonight.
Yes,
wherever you are, I want you to begin to come. You want to give your life to Christ? Or you fell into any of those things I mentioned? This covering is for all. So that we can address other things. As we take that song, please step forward. This is the last day of the feast. And Jesus is beckoning to you. As his blood is crying, the blood of sprinkling crying. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. Just take your step and come out now.
Let me hide
myself
in
your
arms.
Let me
hide
myself in
your
just come forward quickly.
Let me hide
myself
in your arms.
Just come forward. Just come forward.
Let me
want to give your life to Jesus Christ.
My boy is watching you. Let me.
The redemption of your soul is very expensive. Just come, just come. Thank you, Father.
Let me from.
Just come forward, brother, sister. Take the step of faith. The blood of Jesus,
yes, amen,
is the antidote, is the solution for the problem of sin. He is the only one who can hide you. Let the water and the blood from the river side will flow, be of sin.
Yes, amen.
Just step forward, brother. We don't have the time, sister. We don't have the time. Take the step. Tell the devil shame on you. Come forward, come forward. We are waiting for you. We are waiting for you. Let the court of heaven declare you not guilty tonight. Thank you, Father. Rock of ages. And give thanks to God for the blood of Jesus. No drop was left in his vein. The ground collected all. Thank God for this salvation. The redemption of your soul, the Bible says, is precious. Serious affliction. Until the day this brother recognized the power in the blood of Jesus. That was the day his liberty came. Are you under oppression? You are born again, but there's oppression in your life. I want you to step out. Let's join faith together. Whatever is the oppression, every night on that oppression of the wicked, pressed up, pressed down, beating marks all over. Come forward. Come forward. The blood of Jesus is a stronghold. It's a stronghold. The Bible says, enter into your stronghold, you prisoner of hope. He said, today I will deliver you from the waterless pit. Are you under any oppression? Just come. We don't have the time. Our time is actually up. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. The blood covenant is a powerful weapon. Please, if you are coming, do that quickly.
Because
in the cross,
in the cross, in my glory,
get ready for calm. Of spiritual upsurge. The Diocese of Abuja Anglican Communion invites you to the 2024 Diocesan Annual Lenten Meditation, titled The Way of the Cross 2024. Theme, The Blood of Jesus, A Better Covenant. It's a season of consecration.
My glory, those of you in front, I want you to begin to pray and thank God for the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is the speaker. He speaks better things. You have been under oppression, but tonight is the night. There is a hedge around you, the hedge of protection, a stronghold, the place of safety. Tonight, every oppression and the oppressor, they meet their destruction. By the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
We lift up your name. We give you praise. We appreciate you for the blood of Jesus Christ. This is the holy mountain we have come. Presence of innumerable company of angels. From the new covenant, the blood of sprinkling that speaks to your children. Every oppression comes to an end now. Whatever oppression, whatever captivity the enemy has subjected, free. Tonight you are loosed. In the name of Jesus, the blood come against every oppression by the blood of Jesus. Of this oppression by the blood of Jesus. You agent in the name of Jesus, by the they enter their stronghold tonight. The word of God says today, God said he will deliver them from the waterless pit. You are delivered. You are delivered. You are delivered. In the name of Jesus, receive double restoration. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are covered with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Let's rise and go back. Shall we rise? Want to take some prayers?
Yeah, Jean-Doua.
And I know you are ready to pray. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. The name of Jesus is powerful.
Yes, I'm a Kalaidede.
We just take it three times. Then we have overcome by the blood of the
Lamb.
We have overcome. We have overcome.
We have overcome by the blood, by the blood of the Lamb, by the blood.
At a particular month, this sore will come out. Then signs of sanity, insanity will come up. She begin to behave anyhow. As soon as the moon is over, she becomes normal, waiting for another year. And I got to know that this month is the month of June. I said, June, that is my birth month. Is somebody hearing me? I said, my birthday, my month is June. And the particular day, June 8th. So as that date was coming, the family was apprehensive. I told her, I said, bring her to my parsonage. Let me see the devil that will enter my parsonage on the day of my birthday to oppress a parishioner. And that was the day that nonsense ended. Tonight, that nonsense will end in your life. I said that nonsense will end in your life. Look, there are projections, sir. People project things into the moon. They project things into the sun. That is why the word of God says, the sun will not smite you by day. The moon will not smite you by night. You are going to lift up your voice and speak to the natural elements. Every demonic progression, every demonic projection into the moon, into the sun, into the stars, the heavenly galaxies, to turn my blessings to a curse, I reverse them by the blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Every projection to the moon, the word of God says, the moon shall not smite me. That night, take authority over every demonic
projection. Under every satanic order, where projections have been made to change your blessing, to turn your blessing into a curse, lift up your voice by the blood of Jesus. Cancel. Every projection, every demonic projection working against your family, working against your health, working against your business, working against your ministry, cancel it by the blood of Jesus. The Bible says, to overcome him by the blood of the Lamb, by the blood of the Lamb, to overcome him by the blood of the Lamb, in the name of Jesus. Whatever could send Satan, whatever could send Satan out of heaven, whatever could stop Satan in heaven, can stop him on earth. Can stop him on earth. Lift up your voice. Speak by the blood of Jesus. Against every order. Lift up your voice. Against every demonic projection. Against any voice speaking against you. Speaking against your children. Speaking against your health. Speaking against your family. Lift up your voice. Shout in faith protection. Kaya boriga balabalaba. Lift up your voice in the name of Jesus. Lord, we take authority over every demonic projection. Demonic projection in the realm of the spirit to afflict favor in decree by the blood of Jesus. Another prayer point before the last one. Balak.
Balak.
Told Balaam.
Wagan Balaam ge.
Build 7 altars.
Yekwa abayi muguta aba.
And he prescribed the animals to be sacrificed.
Wagwu aya obasi ana obasi but then obasi wa jia paniche.
That altar failed.
Ange gebojo kulaye.
He went to another corner.
Walo atabodal kodo.
He said build another 7.
Wagwu muguta aba jon.
That one again failed. You are going to lift up your voice. Because the time came, God sent a man of God to Bethel to prophesy against the altar that Jeroboam set up. Every altar set up, wherever tonight you are here with the voice of prophecy. As you speak, heaven will back you up. As you prophesy, heaven will back you up. In the name of Jesus, you are going to lift up your voice. Every altar raised against me, raised against my life, raised against my family, raised against my destiny, I prophesy against you in the name of Jesus. Oh, you altar, hear the voice of the Lord. I take authority by the blood of Jesus against you, against the priest, against the demonic priestess, in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice right now and begin to prophesy. In the name of Jesus, Lakota Tara, Lekata Boskia Rosa
In the name of Jesus, oh, you demonic altar, you satanic altar, we take authority by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we prophesy against you, 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 be uprooted from the foundations, be uprooted from the foundations. We render powerless every projection in the name of Jesus. Every projection in the name of Jesus. Every demonic projection in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus. By the word of our testimony. The word of prophecy. The word of prophecy. The word of prophecy. The word of prophecy. You demonic order. All you balance. All you balance. All you order. Altars of iniquity, altars of poverty, altars of sicknesses, altars of diseases, altars of lust, altars, we speak against you in the name of Jesus. We speak against you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Bravo. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
We take the last prayer point for tonight. The blood of Jesus is a better covenant. God said to the children of Israel,
yes, but that's how I get.
Through Moses and Aaron, say, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Passover is a daily experience. You are going to decree in the remaining days of this year. You will decree, I am under the blood of Jesus. Say with me, Father. Shout it louder. Say, Father. I come under the blood covenant tonight. In the remaining days of 2024, I am under the stronghold, the blood of Jesus. I am safe. My family is safe. My job is secure. I am protected. On the highway, I'm protected. On the airway, I'm protected. The airspace, I'm protected. In the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus is my stronghold. I am not afraid. In the name of Jesus, I go through the remaining days of this year under the blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice and make this declaration. To receive glory, he died to receive honor, shed his blood to receive everything good.
We take this song to round off. Thank you, Lord. He alone is worthy. No man on earth should give glory to himself. All the glory must be to the Lord, to the Lord. All the glory must be to the Lord. It's the only way to the Lord. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. His blood made us whole. His blood made us whole. Please, maybe just another 2-3 minutes.
We were double to water.
He touched me.
To
thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
He touched me.
To
he touched me. He touched me.
The Spirit of God.
The
Bible says there are three that bear witness. The blood, the Spirit, and the water. They all are three as one. Three that bear witness. Something is happening. There are three that bear witness on earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood.
Yes, amen. Oh, amen. But the, new one.
The three agree as one.
Mama, that's like
something is happening.
Yesu jimbolo bo we gailo wa duwa lo
Shaka iboska iboska. Healing is taking place. Peace that passes all understanding is flooding people's hearts right now. The Holy Spirit is doing His work. The power of God is at work. Two more times, the same song.
It touched me. Jesus touched me.
Give Him thanks, give Him praise for what He has started, what He has accomplished. Thank you, Lord. It is testimonies from now henceforth. Testimonies after this program. It is testimony time. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. Bring your prayer to a close. Thank you, Father. Lord, we return all glory to you. For the year 2024, the way of the cross. We thank you for the blood of Jesus, a better covenant. Lord God, we thank you for our redemption. We thank you for our preservation. Thank you for the speaking blood. In the remaining days of this year, Lord, we thank you for we have found shelter, Lord, in this stronghold. Lord, no longer are we vulnerable to the attacks of the enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. We celebrate this victory. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Please put your hands together for Jesus once again. Hallelujah. Time will come for appreciation. But today is the last day, just as we have been hearing. the last day of this program. And by the grace of God, the word of God has been confirmed tonight. I said the word of God has been confirmed tonight. The word of God has been confirmed tonight. And testimonies abound in the name of Jesus Christ. That same scriptures, before we go into taking of offering, I will read it again and we will take it home and we will run with it in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, like I said, today is the last day of this program, and usually today we collect offering in support of the Way of the Cross of 2025. How many of us want to see 2025 and partake in what God is going to do? This is the time to sow the seed, and those seeds will speak for you in the name of Jesus Christ. So we call on us to give very, very good offering tonight. What can help us set a pace for next year? What can give the organizing committee confidence to say, well, we want to organize Way of the Cross program? Please, it is tonight you do it. Don't think about the economic circumstances of Nigeria today. You do not depend on the economy of Nigeria, but on the economy of heaven. And God is going to do it, using you and I to do it in the name of Jesus Christ. So as I call on St. Matthew, Jesus stood and said in a loud voice, "If anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink." The flow of the drink of God is flowing abundantly to every one of us. And every one of us shall drink of it. We have already started to drink of it. The team from Maitama, please lead us as we take offering for tonight.
Can we, somebody shout hallelujah? Rise on your feet as we give glory to Jesus.
We appreciate you, O God, for the offering of your children. As you have accepted them this evening, the Lord, they will continue to see your hand at work. That you will give unto them to drink that flow. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I would like His Lordship, our Father in God, primate tonight, the right Tabuai,
praise he the Lord, praise he the Lord. On behalf of His Grace, the leader of our church, my father and mentor, I want to implore all of us to please stand and stretch forth our hands towards the bishop who has just delivered a powerful sermon. Let's pray and ask God to renew his strength. Pray for God's anointing, fresh anointing on daily basis. Virtue have gone out of him. Ask the Lord to refill him. Pray for his diocese, his dear wife, the children. Ask the Lord to shield them. Pray and soak them with the blood of Jesus. That this same blood will speak for them. This same blood will do violence to the kingdom of darkness. Ask the Lord to do all he can do in his life, in his episcopacy. Ask the Lord to disgrace and disappoint his enemies. Pray that his seat will never be empty. That he will finish well. Pray for double grace upon his life. Pray for open doors. Pray that the hand of the Lord will continue to rest upon his life. That he will always be at the right place at the right time, continue to do the right thing. That the hands of the evil ones shall not locate him. And so shall it be forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for your son, the Right Reverend Olorifemi, the Bishop of Isako Diocese. We are grateful for using him mightily today again. We ask, O God, that which you have done through him and in him shall be permanent. In the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that no weapon formed against his life and his episcopacy, his diocese, the family, shall prosper. In the name of Jesus, your health will not fail you. The health of your wife will not fail her. None of you shall die suddenly in the name of Jesus. You shall fulfill your dreams and destinies in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. We soak you with the blood of Jesus Christ. Soak your children, your wife, with the blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Abba Father, because we know you have answered our prayer. For in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. It is done. Please be seated. All glory, honor, dominion, power, and majesty be ascribed unto the Lord. We thank God for this rare privilege. I am humbled. I'm not taking this privilege for granted. I've been asked to stand in for my father, our leader, the bishop, the metropolitan archbishop, and the prophet of all Nigeria at this Way of the Cross last day program. I want to thank my mother, Mama Abuja, Mama Province, Mama Nigeria, and Mama Africa for this rare privilege to share this fellowship together. Mama, by the grace of God, you and Baba, your children and grandchildren will continue to enjoy good health, sound mind, long life, and prosperity. You have started very well. We pray that the primacy of our dear father and mama will continue to flourish like palm trees in Jesus' name. You shall continue to experience peace in the name of Jesus. And the reign of God shall continue to radiate, and not only in Church of Nigeria, but the entire world, in Jesus' name. So we are grateful, and we pray that wherever Baba may be at this point, that the Lord will be with him. The purpose of his journey shall be achieved. So shall it be, in Jesus' name. So, Mama, we are grateful. Thank you so much. We also want to thank the Right Reverend Joseph Musa, who started day one and two, and he spoke powerfully. And we are all blessed. We are grateful for his episcopacy. And we pray that the Lord will continue to prosper him and grant him his heart desires in Jesus' name. We thank our Father in God, the Right Reverend Felix Olorifemi. Thank you so much once again on behalf of the primate. We are grateful for what the Lord have used you and shall continue to use you. By the grace of God, you shall be relevant forever in Jesus' name. We thank our brother, the Venerable Chinonso Anomba, the counselor and engineer, Mrs. Miss Ikide. Thank you so much. From Gwagolada, the Lord will honor you all in Jesus' name. The supervising priest, the rural deans, vicars, and all clergy of this great diocese of Abuja, the Lord will honor all of you. You shall all reach the peak of your careers. None of you shall be stranded in the name of Jesus Christ. We want to appreciate the vicar of All Saints Church, especially WUSE Abuja in particular, and members of All Saints Church, WUSE. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for accommodating this year's program. The Lord will reward you handsomely and openly, and nothing good will die in your hands in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you so much. We appreciate the ACNN crew. We appreciate you for what you do for God. The Lord will honor you. He will establish you. He will showcase your lives. So shall it be in Jesus' name. All the Saint Church Media team, All Saint Church Media team, you are appreciated. Guild of Stewards, you are appreciated. The security team, both outside and those inside the church, we appreciate you. The Lord will bless you. You will never miss your reward in Jesus' name. We want to, again, sincerely thank the retired clergymen, retired, not tired, our fathers in God,
The first is the Venerable and Mrs. Pure Okoromade MNION. Ameto and Mama, we are grateful. Most sincerely, the Lord will renew your strength daily like the eagles in Jesus' name. We thank Baba, the Venerable, and Mrs. Olushongu Majekodomi. Thank you so much, our Mama. God bless you, Grandpa. The Lord will renew your strength. You shall continue to enjoy your retirement in Jesus' name. And we want to thank also everyone that has participated in the way of the cross of this year. We have been blessed. I have been blessed. I have been blessed. May this blessing be permanent in our lives. In the name of Jesus. I say, may this blessing be permanent in our lives. In the name of Jesus. The Lord will honor all of you. He will prosper you. He will fight your battles for you. In the name of Jesus. And by the grace of God, I join my faith with the father, the leader of our church, our father, our mentor, to pray for all of you that by this time next year, none of you shall be missing. You will not be missing. I will not be missing. In the name of Jesus. By the grace of God, the blessings that we have all received at this way of the cross this year with the theme, the blood of Jesus, a better covenant, this blood shall continue to speak for you. It shall speak for your children. It shall speak for your family. It shall speak for your finances. It shall speak for your careers. If you believe that, let your enemy be like thunder. And so, as you step out from here this day, go and possess your possession. Go and recover all. Go and recover everything you, both locally and internationally, in the go and dominate. In the name of Jesus. Go and be celebrated. Go and recover your joy. Go and recover your peace. Recover your businesses. Go and recover your careers. Go and recover Jesus. I join the faith of our Father. Your enemies will not speak before you. You will not die before your time. You shall fall. In the name of Jesus, to any voice speaking evil against you, shall in the name of Jesus, the Lord shall give you a testimony that will. In the name of Jesus, the Lord shall give you a testimony or answer prayers. Your coming here will not be in vain. In the name of Jesus, whatever may have not been working well in your lives, in your careers, in your finances, in your businesses before now, we begin to work in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. We pray for our father, our mama, and the entire family of our primate, the bishop, archbishop, and metropolitan,
The Lord shall continue to fight their battles, and they shall hold their peace. In the name of Jesus, nothing will deflate their joy. Nothing will sour their joy. In the name of Jesus, they shall enjoy sound mind, good and robust health, with longevity of life. So shall it be forever in the name of Jesus. As you go at your appearance, your enemy shall disappear. You shall be ahead of your enemies. In the name of Jesus, the remaining days and months of this year, by the grace of God, we join our faith with the faith of our Father. You are unshakable. You are unmovable. You are indestructible. You are unkillable. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. Unto God's gracious mercy, protection, favor, we commit you. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord watch over your lives. The Lord give you peace. Peace in your heart. Peace in your finances. Peace in your careers. Peace in your families. Both now and forevermore. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Shalom.